keep the lawn green without spending a fortune on water and fertilizer.
Fox 4's Dan Godwin's at the Texas A&M Agriculture Center, or AgriLife Center in North Dallas.
Yes,
it's a made-up word.
I know, that's where turf scientists are creating better lawns. So after this, send them my way, Dan.
Yes, indeed. Very valuable information for so many homeowners. As you guys were talking about, this time of year in North Texas, lawns take a beating. Front yard and back, that Texas sun can be pretty unforgiving. Well, here at the Texas A&M AgriLife Research Center, they are developing varieties of turf that are better than what's in your yard right now. Great to say hello to Dr. Ambika Chandra, the lead turf building scientist here at the AgriLife Center. Good morning. Thank you for joining us. We want to take a look at the two trays here. Right over here, let's start with this one. Okay. These were both of these trays, this turf, developed by you personally, right, Dr. Chandra?
Yes, it was developed right here at the Dallas Center by me and my team, a breeding scientist.
Right. Now, what we're looking at here is called Tamstar. It's a variation on St. Augustine, a type of grass that a lot of people would be familiar with. But this is better. How so?
This is Tamstar St. Augustine grass is better because it is drought tolerant. So what that means is that it's going to require less amount of water to maintain a healthy turf.
Not only less water, it'll get by with a lot fewer chemicals, less fertilizer, less pesticides.
Absolutely, and that is because of its genetics. It was developed, it is highly tolerant to diseases and insect pressure, insect damage. And so what that means is that it's going to require less amount of fungicides, insecticides, just less chemicals.
Okay, and another improvement on a lot of turf that's out there now. This one doesn't have a name yet. It's still in the final sort of development phases. We'll refer to it as 0802, but a variety again on Zoysia type grass. Now, this is again commonly used golf courses, maybe industrial parks, wide, vast expanses of lawn, but also residential purposes.
Absolutely.
And again, this is an improvement. This is a better breed of turf, again, for the reasons you discussed with the St. Augustine.
Right. And one of the added characteristic on the Zoysia grass, KSU-0802, is that it can tolerate the heat just as well it can tolerate the cold. Stress. So it is adapted in South Texas as well as North Texas. And so it's really good grass, requires less water, just a less amount of chemicals, and has good temperature tolerance.
Okay, here at the AgriLife Center, there's a lot of excitement about a construction project that's going on. Now, really, this center, this place here in North Dallas, is arguably the world's leading center when it comes to developing new kinds of turf, but also lots of other agriculture for urban and suburban settings. And tell us about this. How will this new headquarters help?
So we are really excited about this new development, new construction here. What I'm really excited about is new research laboratories and new research greenhouses that will be part of the new development. And that will really enable us to do cutting-edge science and make even more scientific advancements in the future. So I'm really excited about that.
Okay.
And actually, there's a lot more information on our website, dallas.tamu.edu. That viewers can go look at.
Yes, and we will have those websites on our site a little bit later this morning. Again, the Tamstar available now from some growers, and it'll become more available in the future, as will the new 0802, yet to have a name. Coming up in the next hour of Good Day, we'll take your lawn care questions. You can send those questions to our Facebook page, Good Day Fox 4. For now, reporting live in North Dallas, Dan Godwin, back to Tim and Lauren.